I just wanted to come on here really quickly and make a video. I will be looking down here because I just want to, again, make it really quick and read off what I wanted to say. Concise. So I wanted to pop on and make a quick statement about the Wet'suwet'en situation, considering this is the International Day of Action in response to the recent court injunction and the RCMP takeover. If you don't know, the Wet'suwet'en Nation is in northwestern BC, kind of, and they have had a blockade up the Unist'ot'en camp, opposing the entrance of gas companies without consent to their traditional territories for the past 10 years. The Gnimmaten camp is before Unist'ot'en and has recently been having a face-off with Coastal GasLink officials who want to trespass to complete their LNG pipeline that was never consented to. Yesterday, the court issued an injunction to allow GasLink to enter and sent off the RCMP to enter the territory without the consent of the hereditary chiefs and disassemble the Gnimmaten checkpoint camp. 14 peaceful protesters were arrested for defending their land. I, along with many others, stand in solidarity with the Wet'suwet'en Nation. I did try to attend the rally on the legislature lawn in Victoria today. However, I went after class, so I was a little late and I couldn't find them, but my heart is with them and that's why I am making this video. I will do what I can. So there's no treaty on Wet'suwet'en territory, so it is unceded land. There's no land claim agreement, and therefore there was never a consensual transfer of control and authority from the people who have lived upon and stored this land since time immemorial. And mainland BC is unique for this compared to the rest of the country because there are no historical treaties agreeing upon the colonial sovereignty of invading foreign nations. So that's why there are big court cases like Delgamuukw and Chilcotin that deal with these land claim, right and title claim issues. And you know, the results of these court cases should actually be listened to. And I personally think that this is going to result in a similar decision because that's how we come about anything in BC due to the environment, the nature of the colonial claimed territory, the false nature of that. As the late Arthur Manuel articulated so well, the court injunction is the state's legal billy club, used to skirt not only the fundamentals of a nation-to-nation relationship, but to combat any resistance to a superimposed colonial authority. Not only is this undemocratic and unethical, but it is essentially an act of terrorism. Yeah, I just wanted to pop on here and say that, give you a little information if you don't know what's going on. Also, I would just look up CBC and then look at what they've said about it. Because it's a lot more detailed. However, I did just want to say something, especially because I couldn't attend the protest today, unfortunately. Yeah, we can't sit by and let this happen. It's purely unethical. So, yeah, okay.